things today. One, I'd like to give you a status report. I want to identify the factors that led to intervention. And I want to identify the corrective steps that I'll be taking this year. To state the obvious, you will find no great cities without strong public schools. 85 to 90% of all school-age children in this state, as well as this nation, attend our public schools. So I think it's quite obvious that if we're going to make great strides, the public schools will have to be a major part of the equation. And I would say to you that in spite of the Montgomery intervention and in spite of some of the problems that we have, we cannot accept just a few good schools scattered around, whether it's strong private or parochial schools, or whether we have a handful of public schools that do well. And I would say to you in that context, other than a few select schools within the Montgomery Public School System, a place where I started my career, by the way, Montgomery Public Schools are not a strong school system. And I think we need to come to grips with that. We need to quit making excuses for that. And we need to be prepared to take some significant steps to address the factors that have contributed. We all know what they are. It's just a matter of having the courage and commitment to do it. I want to throw out one side issue. This, as I said, I started my career here in Montgomery. I spent most of my adult life here in Montgomery, so I feel I have some identity here. But you would have to broach the question if you were even a casual observer of this environment. Do we see the need for strong public schools? And in terms, and also in that, do we really want strong public schools? Before you answer that, let me add another sentence or two. For at least the past two decades, 20 years or more, parents have been taking their children to Autauga County, Elmore County, city systems like Auburn, Pike Road schools, private schools, and parochial schools. So the demise of this system should not be a surprise to anyone. It didn't happen yesterday. It's been going on for a long time. So I raise that same question again. Do you really want strong public schools in Montgomery? A status report. Currently, the Montgomery Public Schools intervention is based on two major areas, finance and student achievement. And I would say to you, contrary to previous announcements, the entire school system is under intervention, not just a few schools. I would say in fairness to the Montgomery Public Schools that the initial intervention model that was used was poorly designed. And as a result of that, I've been here almost 3 months, although I've been here before, but hopefully I'll get it right the second time. But in my first 2 months that I've been here, I've done nothing but damage control to try to unravel that model and to make sure that we can move very quickly to correct the problems. Because you have to keep in mind that every year that we delay, another several thousand students exit our system, and we have again underserved them. My term of office in this intervention model should end sometime in May, so I can assure you only of a couple of things. financial situation, and I will hopefully have in place a model for the academic or student achievement situation in place for the next state superintendent to pick up. I would say to you that my experience in dealing with intervention, and I've had experiences with systems from Huntsville to Mobile, a total of almost 20, so I've been down this road before. But when they're experiencing these problems, several well-defined patterns develop. And I would like to just identify some of those characteristics because I think you're going to see where you are in Montgomery. First of all, you have a pattern of declining student achievement levels. We've got that. You have weak administration. It comes usually in two packages. One, we don't really want strong principals. We want to hire some people that we know. And if they don't do well, we'll move them to another school and maybe they'll do better later. And I'm not just saying Montgomery. Every one of those systems I've identified, that's been a pattern. That's here too. You have a board of education usually that's more interested in being reelected than educating students. And I think the tipping point, and I use that in the context of when you reach that point, you start to fall off the cliff. The tipping point is with hundreds of students start to leave your school system. It starts with a few hundred. I could use Birmingham as an example, and then it got to well over 1,000 a year. This year, Montgomery Public Schools lost 790 students. Not only is that a loss of state funds of $1.5 billion, it's equivalent to a school. So I think I would summarize those characteristics in this way. If you are committed to strong public schools in Montgomery, now is the time for perhaps your last best chance. Because that number is going to accelerate, and obviously what you're going to end up with is reduced capacity in many of the large urban centers that you can see around this country. You're going to have the same problems here. I would say to you that even though the Montgomery City Council and the mayor have been very supportive, they just slid into my hands. So I feel like pounding the table here saying, I'm going to go here. Whoever's in charge, you're doing a good job here. And the city council's done what it could, in my view. The county commission has stepped up to take some real risk in terms of resources for the Montgomery Public Schools. And the Education Foundation has, for a number of years, taken steps that oftentimes unforeseen, but have great potential. And I commend all of those for addressing the issue of funding for Montgomery. Indeed, minimal funding impedes progress. But let me make sure you understand, I am not recommending that additional funds at this time be provided, because to say for a system that has not managed its funds as it should to give them more money